Tonality refers to the systematic arrangement of pitches and the relations between them, meaning keys, chords, and scales. Exposure to the music of your culture gives you implicit knowledge of how it goes. That lets you form expectations for melody and harmony. Implicit learning is the kind that happens without conscious effort, through merely being in an environment where music is present. In comparison, explicit learning is the kind that takes attention and focus, which you get from taking music lessons. A child growing up in a house with a lot of music in the background has a more developed sense of tonality than another child who doesn't hear music very often. If neither of these children takes music lessons, their sense of tonality is less developed than the kid next door who practices music. Musical training adds knowledge. Knowledge informs perception. Just as a top chef can pick out the individual flavors in a sauce, so can a trained musician pick out the individual tones in a chord. Scholars since the time of the ancient Greeks have shown interest in the distinction between consonants, or pleasant sounding, and dissonance, or unpleasant sounding. They've asked to what extent a tonal music system is based upon an objective property of sound versus simply tradition or cultural norms. Does our music system reflect psychological or physiological limits? Well, the answer is yes to both of those questions. Scales are built using fewer than 10 pitch chroma, meaning 10 individual keys on a piano, because a small number reduces the cognitive load on working memory, the type of memory used to track melodic information. Most of the world's scales are built using 7 plus or minus 2 pitches due to limits on our cognitive abilities. 7 is roughly the number of items we can manage in working memory, and so cognitive constraints limit our scales to make them relatively easy to learn and memorize. Our musical scales also feature unequal step sizes because it makes it easier to find the tonic in a given key. For example, the distance between pitches E and F is 1 semitone, but between F and G, it's 2 semitones. If the distance between all tones were the same, as in equal step sizes, studies with infants have shown that it becomes harder to know where you are in the scale. When infants were taught a brand new scale with unequal step sizes, their memory performance was very good. In fact, they learned it as easily as the culturally familiar Western tonal scale. Both infants and adults failed at learning a new scale with equal step sizes. Music listeners reference a sense of tonality when they're judging goodness of fit for individual pitches in a tonal context. Musical knowledge has an impact. Without formal musical training in pitch relationships, listeners tend to regard the distance from the tonic as the mediator of how well a given pitch fits the tonality. For example, the graph on the right shows that non-musicians judged the pitch of G to fit about as well as G sharp does in a C major scale. The musician group on the left recognized that a G belonged with C much better than with G sharp. Consonant and dissonant dyads interact differently in the cochlea of the inner ear. Dissonant dyads cause mechanical interference. This is termed beating or roughness. Early scholars concluded that dissonance must reflect an innate conflict, and that consonance, with its absence of beating or roughness, must be the voice of the more pleasant gods. This sensory and philosophical distinction has guided our understanding of tonality, compelling centuries of music composers to use consonant intervals to convey harmoniousness and release, and dissonant intervals to convey instability and tension. Tonality and harmonicity influences how we speak. When we're happy, we tend to speak in consonant intervals, like perfect fifths and major thirds. When we are angry or upset, we speak in narrow dissonant intervals, even using the tritone. Emotional responses to music are based upon how we use the intervals in our speech to convey intentionality and our mood. And that depends on the musical culture in which we were raised. In the next video, we will look at culture general and culture specific differences in music.